All right, good afternoon, everybody. It's your boy Akeem, and welcome to today's vlogs. I'm gonna finally finish things off with my final previews of the Big Ten Conference for today. Got four more blocks in the West Division. For this blog, I'm here to talk about the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Last season, this team surprised me a lot, going 9-4, and they actually had some key departures entering last season, but they still had a great year. They did wrap it off with a loss in the Music City Bowl against a good Tennessee Volunteer team. Now, this season, they're going to have the new player at quarterback and Tanner Lee, who's going to take full control. Tommy Armstrong's no longer with the team. He spent his years of eligibility that he had left, and he actually had a great career, decent career as a Cornhusker, despite not winning a Big Ten championship. It was still a respectable career for Armstrong. Now, for this season, for Tanner Lee, I think he's actually the better passer or quarterback between Armstrong and Lee, so I do have high hopes in the passing attack for the Cornhusker offense. This season, though, they are going to have to play without their top wide receivers, and Jordan Westernkamp and Brandon O'Reilly. They actually are out because of their eligibility as well, but they do have the return of all-purpose player and Stanley Morgan Jr., and I think he could be a good threat, not only as a wide receiver, but also in special teams. He could possibly garner all Big Ten honors at the end of this season. Now, the other receivers who's going to have to step it up is DeMarney Pearson, a senior, and junior Brian Remus. I think these two players are going to have to step it up as far as the receiver core to help complement and Morgan. Now, as far as the running back position, their leading rusher and Terrell Newby is no longer with the team. This means Mikel Wilborn and Trey Bryant is going to have to split some carries at the backfield, and hopefully one of them could be they start at running back. Now, in the offensive line, though, they do have some experience, but they do have young players as well, and Gacy is actually going to be leading that offensive line. He is their best lineman in the offensive unit. They also have Gerard Foster, Tanner Farmer, the guards, and center Michael Decker. I think they have a pretty decent offensive line. Now, heading over to the defensive unit, I think they had a pretty good defense last season, except for the games that they lost, particularly in a 62-point blowout that they lost to against Ohio State, giving up 62 points. That was a poor performance. So they actually have a new addition in the defensive side with a new coordinator coming out of UConn, former head coach and Bob Diaco. Things did not work out well for the UConn Huskies under head coach Bob Diaco, but he decided to sign up to become the DC for the Nebraska Cornhuskers, and I do wish him the best of luck. He is a better defensive-minded coach. Now, they do have a couple of players who's actually no longer on the defensive unit, and Kevin Maurice and Ross Desiris. They're actually one of their top defensive linemen if you look at the defensive line position. But they do have the return of Carlos Davis, who is a sophomore who I have high hopes on, as well as junior Freedom Akeem Walanda. Sorry if I mispronounced your name. I'm not really good at pronouncing names. In the linebacker core, they have a couple of decent players I am looking at in Marcus Newby and Chris Webber. I think they can be good leaders in the defensive unit. But as far as the secondary, they do have just about the entire secondary returning and great players. Actually, among these three players I'm going to talk about, they had 11 interceptions combined last season, and Aaron Williams, Keyron Williams, and Chris Jones. They have great experience as far as the secondary, and I think that this defense can definitely do better off this upcoming season with that great secondary returning. Now, it's time for me to take a look at their schedule. They're going to have a tough schedule ahead of him. Now, their first big matchup is a rematch of last year's win over the Oregon Ducks on September the 9th. This game is going to be played at Eugene, though, so the Ducks is looking to avenge last season's loss, and I actually picked the Ducks to win that matchup, but the Nebraska quarterback Tommy Armstrong had better plans, had other plans in mind in that matchup. He had helped lead the team to a great victory. October the 7th is going to be played against Wisconsin. That is a Big Ten West showdown in that one. October the 14th against the Ohio State Buckeyes, who smashed the Cornhuskers last season in a 62-3 victory. November the 4th against Northwestern. Northwestern is a team that you have to look out, keep an eye on as well. November the 11th at Minnesota, another Big Ten West matchup. November the 18th at Penn State. Penn State's looking to repeat as Big Ten champions. And on the 24th, they're going to be hosting Iowa. That could be Big Ten championship implications in that one. It's going to be a tight race. Now, looking at this schedule, I'm a little bit concerned for the Cornhuskers. I don't think they're going to go 9-4 again. They're another 9-win season. I think that was a shocker, especially with a new quarterback. I'm not really too confident in the athleticism in Tommy Lee. I think this team is going to go 7-5 this season and drop. Even with the addition of Bob Diaco, he is a pretty good defensive-minded coach. I'm just not really completely sold on the offense, particularly at the receiver position with only Stanley Morgan returning. They have a new set of running backs, a new quarterback, so it's too much of a coin toss for me. I actually have this team still having a winning season and becoming bowl eligible, going 7-5 overall. Now, the next time I'm going to catch you guys will be in a couple minutes. I have three more blogs for today. Thank you for watching this blog. I'm your man, Akeem McCall. Be easy.